Preseason opener for these two teams, and it should be a good one, as it'll be the New York Jets taking on the Carolina Panthers. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and we finally made it, partner, through the winter, through the spring, now into the summer, and football finally back.
And during that time off, we all cherish our vacation time, but admit it, you're the same as me. When you were working out, when you were doing things, you thought about football, didn't you? And you couldn't wait to be back up here again.
Two teams more than ready to get this one started. And off we go from uptown Charlotte. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Panthers now for their opening drive. They're brought out by a man now in his 15th NFL season, one of the most productive passers in league history, and a former Super Bowl champion, Matthew Stafford.
And Matthew Stafford was taken first overall in the 2009 draft, and he certainly played like a top pick. Throughout his career, he's been one of the most prolific passers in the league, and there's no reason to believe he's going to slow down his production anytime soon. Not only that, he's also one of the tougher quarterbacks in the league as well.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Just need a yard here, 2nd and 1. Again, it's Kamara. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down. Kamara up the middle. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 51 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. So in Jet territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 26-yard line. They'll try the air now with Stafford. Going for it all. Oh, his first throw of the game. Going to be intercepted. Picked off by Pat Surtain. And the Jets are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover.
Well, they certainly took a shot to open this game. And I know it backfired with the interception, but no lack of bravado from that sideline at all. And look, they told us before the ball game, they wanted to be a little more dangerous on offense.
So here come the Jets for their initial possession of the game. And bringing them out is a player who's a dual-threat quarterback who started 4 years at Louisville, and that's Malik Cunningham.
We're seeing it more and more in this league, how teams love to have athletes back there taking the snaps, guys who can throw it and move around and get yards with their legs if needed. he's one of the best examples that we see out there right now. He can throw for hundreds of yards one week and then run for 100-plus the next. He adds an extra dimension that really confounds defenses when he puts it all together.
9 yards is the pick. Gibbs here. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Jet first down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That's some good closing speed there defensively, because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up. Converged on his man and broke the play up.
And no room that time. Getting it to about the 46. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming.
Vision is so important for the man in the middle, because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. One heck of a third down conversion. 33 yards. Defender was right there in his shorts. Is that one of those situations as a DB where you just tip your cap and say, nice catch?
Well, you're supposed to, but a true competitor, he's not tipping his cap at all. He's upset he still didn't make the play. If it's a 50-50 ball or a moment of truth, he's got to win more than his fair share of them as well.
Probably especially angry because if it was incomplete, would have been 4th down.
Exactly.
Now, here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver.
And that's something you have to get ready for defensively, because in today's NFL, teams will use their wide receivers on jet sweeps, end arounds. They'll move them back in the backfield to make them running backs. Partner, this was much more of a tap pass, but effective nonetheless.
And I think both guys love it. If you're a quarterback, it's an easy completion. If you're a wide receiver, you get the easy reception and also a chance to try to make a play with your feet. Cunningham looking to throw. Dancing to his left. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
I haven't met a quarterback yet that didn't enter the league with a massive chip on his shoulder. If he wasn't a first-round pick, they want to show the league that they made a big mistake. Determined to get the first down there, no hesitation at all to tuck it and go. I bet he would have tried running through their entire defense if it meant reaching that marker.
And he'll be taken down here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Now the second-year man from Alabama, it's Brian Robinson. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a 3rd and goal. So now things get interesting on 3rd and goal from the 1.
This almost becomes a Darwinian call, doesn't it? Almost survival of the fittest here. I know we can go all cliche.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Reggie Gilliam punching it in from a yard away. And the Jets post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. And when the smaller guy can't power it across the goal line, Charles, sometimes you need to go with a fullback. They did. It worked.
What's that thing about force and mass? How's that?
Oh, yeah. Force equals mass times acceleration.
Oh, that's big-time stuff. That's from the same guy the apple dropped on his head, right?
The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their 2nd drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start 1st and 10. The drive starts with a completion left side, and he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Ball on the 27. Here's a second down at 6. Hand off running left, Patterson. And he powers his way up past the 30. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. 3rd and 2, Goff. That is caught, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down. A shotgun snap for Goff. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Patterson. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big play there on the catch and run. And it will result in a fresh set of downs. Play action. It's gone. And he's down into the red zone at the 16 after a gain of 16. First and 10. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, Goff. Now throw right side here, going to be incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep him out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
Oh, what a read on the outside as it's intercepted. Picked off by Darren Hall. And the Jets are going to take over here on the INT at their own 5-yard line. So now it's 2 straight drives that end with an interception.
And the first time, the first interception, they ended up getting 6 points out of it and taking the lead. Now they have an opportunity to increase that lead after their second pick on 2 drives.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
And that run there does nothing but juice up the guys who are moving the football. I mean, if you're an offensive lineman, people running it, actually the guy calling plays, you're almost jumping up and down in jubilation, aren't you?
Yeah, now you've got options on second down.
And big-time options. You might want to think about play action and try and get something cheap right here over the top.
And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. Sets up the screen to Robinson. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down.
So many screen passes are the result of excellent acting by everyone. But sometimes the guy who's getting the ball tips the play off. The running back, because he's eager to get the pass. And sometimes he doesn't act very well about whether he's going to block or leak out or whatever. And I think that they saw that, and that's why they're able to get to him on it.
He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. On first down, here's Mon. Repeat of the last play, going to Mechie here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Now that certainly solidifies how to attack this 2-minute drill right before the half. I don't think they were going to try and run out the clock, but now after that big play, their thoughts are certainly of trying to score and get some points before the half.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Mon gonna throw it. Here's a screen for Robinson. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. A good pickup there of 22.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well, like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens because if he starts feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness against them.
As he gets the sack. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Here's Mon. This ball caught by Mechie. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. On first and 10, here's Mond. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally, I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it, so on comes the field goal unit. And this one is right through, and that will extend their lead even further. So another scoring drive there, Charles, and an early two-score lead.
You'd like the 6 there, partner, but you'll take the 3, and I think they have to be happy by the way they moved the ball in these first 2 drives. They have to feel good about their opportunities the rest of the game.
Halftime in our first preseason matchup. Well, we all miss football in the offseason, but apparently not everybody missed halftime. We skip right over it. We get back to the action. Probably not likely to see many starters in the second half as we get back at it underway in this preseason opener. And the half will begin with a touchback. Here's the Jets offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. First and 10. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Out of the gun, they give to Robinson. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up 3rd down. It's Hawkins. And boy, he is very close to a 1st down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass, a run. What will they do? We're about to find out. 4th down.
And he'll have a Jets 1st down as the tackle made just shy of the 40.
If he writes a book in the offseason, he ought to title it Undaunted, because where he is on the field, back on his own side, and goes for it, and gets it, I got to give it to him on that one.
Yeah, only thing you can justify it with is it was only a few inches that they needed. If it's 4th and 2, probably doesn't do it. Hey, he got it. Give him credit.
Yeah, but they don't pick it up.
Then you're in trouble.
Yeah, they're giving points to the other team at that stage.
And he'll be stopped at the 46, gain of 3. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. 3rd down from the gun, it's Mond. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on 4th down. They'll run for it with Robinson. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a 1st down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. On first down, it's Hawkins. And down inside the 40 to about the 38. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. They'll keep it on the ground. Hawkins, and he gets it down to the 32. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Motion man is Schwartz. And he'll get it here on the touch pass. And he'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. And a stoppage here. We're going to need to take a moment as a Jet was shaken up on that one. Well, injury's never good, especially here in the preseason. Hopefully nothing serious. They'll take a look at him, and we'll step aside for a moment. 2nd down and a run by Robinson. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 45 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
Well, this has been a long drive. In fact, he's eaten up a good chunk of the third quarter, which is precisely what you want when you're playing with the lead. You control the football, you control the clock, and impose your will on the defense.
Motion man is Schwartz. They'll get it forward to him on the touch pass. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. Fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Reggie Gilliam ready for the regular season with his 2nd touchdown of the game. And the Jets take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Moody good with the extra point. And that makes our score 17-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. And we're back now in Charlotte. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. And the return will stop right around the 25. Flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit. So the special teams up the middle. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Robinson with another carry. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a 1st. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
From the 38 now, here's a 2nd and 4. Up the middle they go. It's Hawkins. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down. Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. 2nd down coming up.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? Was that five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. It's a five-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Robinson will try to pick it up. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and minicamps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and to secure a victory.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. Second down and 4. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and 2. Third down, Robinson. But he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Certainly not the highest of scoring games, Charles. Their offense, yeah, did some okay things. Not a lot of points on the board, but enough for the win with how their defense was playing in this one.
Yeah, they certainly brought their A game, didn't they? They weren't fooled by anything that was presented to them from start to finish. That defense, they might as well have told their offense, guys, just kick a field goal. We've got it today.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Till next time, we say so long from Charlotte.
in the home. Head on the swivel, I always stay on my toes. The ones you love most wanna know what you're safe really old. The world's in the street now, niggas breaking the cold. Smoke of blood pressure, this thing is taking its toll. I'm thankful ain't no shows, I need a break from the road. Put niggas in position, they still ungrateful it shows. Fucking up my energy, shit is making me cold. My life a series of drama, just like them ATO shows. When I die, I'm going out like the Pharaoh, Drake me in gold. I'm still gonna run this shit till I'm 80 years old. They realize I'm lazy, I'm the one that's been taking control. Private table, car balls when we leave Miami Beach. And I brought Santa Beach, your kiss tastes like a can of peaches. You got that shit on you, killing them, not just saying the least. You about to get away with murder, you my Annalise. Got you to bust down Cardi, that's 30 fans at least. Chanel crowd, Chanel bag, hold that Lamborghini. You always held me down, you threw me back when I ran the street. Back when if you wanted some weight, then I was the man to see. Back when I was trapping with a scale and some paraphernalia. Now when I'm buying drip, I get measured and failed. But my accomplishments, some of my day ones never was there for. I just realized they fail like my success is they failure.
Tonight, from MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, it's a special Saturday night edition of the NFL on EA Sports.
Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. That didn't take long to see our first penalty of the game, did it?
We always talk about everyone wanting to get into the game in a hurry. The officials did as well.
Run straight ahead with Achane. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Right away, they rack up 10 yards on their first play from scrimmage. Good job there. Pretty simple. The hole was created. Runner just darted right through.
Yeah, that's kind of play teams are looking for, to have some success early in a ball game. If you're an offensive play caller, you mark that run down. Make sure you keep coming back to it throughout the game until they stop it.
Here's second and 10. Now Prescott finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. Tress Way on fourth down is sent out to punt. And he was looking for the check on bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Second down. They'll run for the first time with a speedster, Jahmyr Gibbs. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation. Gibbs will try and pick it up. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains. couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these are bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time, that's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
And he'll be brought down right at the 35-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a 1st down. They'll go again with Gibbs. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
From just across the midfield stripe, here's a 2nd down and 4.
Gibbs straight ahead. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game. And it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
2nd and 7. Off play action. It's Cunningham. Past the 20, and he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or 2 shy of the 10. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a 1st down.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
On 1st and 10, here's Gibbs. And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. We're scoreless after 1. 2nd quarter now from MetLife Stadium. The Jets with the football here as they've got it with a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Jahmyr Gibbs, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Jets post the 1st points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this 2nd quarter. Moody good with the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it was all capped off by a touchdown run from Jahmyr Gibbs. Taken at the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Is going to put them back with not great field position.
So they really had 0 benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return, then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
Prescott's throw there, taken in by Smith. 2 yards on the pickup there, and it's 2nd down. Prescott throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and now that sets up 3rd and 2. They'll run for it with Achan. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
It's a gain of 16, 1st down Tampa Bay.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that 1st down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. A little bit of daylight on that 1st down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Got a man that's caught at the 6-yard line.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they had been seeking.
They'll run Achane. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 4 on the carry there at 2nd and goal.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, look at a little more of a scat back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Zach Charbonnet taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Buccaneers are an extra point away from drawing level. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line, and he'll be stopped up at the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big pickup of 38. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. Cunningham setting up the screen. This is Gibbs. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Gun here. It's Cunningham toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free, and kept them out of the end zone.
Now a 2nd and 10. Now Cunningham looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Gibbs. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
And he's going to go down here. Sack. They push him back to the 34. Sack by Andrew Van Ginkel.
Yeah, some real defensive resistance there, saying not so fast to a good drive. They had marched to the end zone the last time out.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down went backwards. It's 3rd and very long. Cunningham to throw. He's got this complete to Ridley. Touchdown! Calvin Ridley, 34 yards. And the Jets will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Moody good with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Well, the Bucs going to take over now late in this first half. A slim deficit here in a one-possession game. Not much time left, obviously. We'll see if they can march this down the field, at least get three and take some momentum into the locker room. Escaping the pressure right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. Final play of the half, Prescott. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with a first half of play.
A look around the NFL. We'll have to wait for postgame because we are moving right through halftime and on to the third quarter.
Expect to see a good number of backups going forward as we are back and underway here in preseason week two. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3 for 3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute. But did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it. And afterwards, they'll say, there is never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful in this one.
Now the second-year man from Alabama, it's Brian Robinson. Now what a first down pickup of 8.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. This will be complete to Mechie. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. 39 yards the distance covered on the catch and run.
Oftentimes now offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just help receivers find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. Hand off now to Robinson. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
Following the delay, here's second and 9. They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. Now Mond. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet.
Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. And we'll get a moment here as they look this one over.
Yeah, remember now, the call on the field is what they'll stick with unless they have clear video evidence to the contrary. And I give these officials a lot of credit. Such a tough and demanding job. You and I both know that. Yeah, they make the right call way more often than they get it wrong.
decision to challenge does not pan out, and that's also going to cost him a timeout. Mon looks to throw. Steps away to his left. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Jets take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Moody good with the extra point. And it's now 21-7.
And maybe that's the magic touch right there. They didn't use him at all in the first half, at least running the football. But here they entrust him with some work down in the red zone, and he responds. One carry, one touchdown.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
And he'll push ahead for about three to the 36. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Again, it's Charbonnet. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, three plays, all three short runs, but together a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
On first and 10, it's Charbonnet. We'll get this up to about the 44.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The White's throw complete there to Smith. Just a gain of a couple there. And now it's third and four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. To throw, White. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. Well, certainly those are the types of mistakes they're trying to avoid as they attempt to protect this lead late in the game.
And let's face it, they're hoping that this one doesn't cost them in a significant way. Yeah, one guy committed a penalty, but now the entire defense has to pay the price and try and rise up and overcome it.
And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Second down, it's White. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. And now a handoff to Charbonnet. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Here's second and 2 now from the 3. On the give, here's Charbonnet. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. The Bucs on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Henderson will try to run for the first. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team, both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Bucs try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And this 11-play drive is going to lead to nothing on the scoreboard. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game, but boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense. But now, since they've taken over on downs, a team with the ball, guess what? Going to four-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
They work now on second and nine. Again, it's Robinson. And this will be a gain of right around three from the 7 out to the 10-yard line.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Now a pass hauled in downfield. Down the left sideline. John Metchie, and all the way in, touchdown, New York. John Metchie, an even 90 yards. And the Jets have put this one to bed here in the fourth quarter. Now Moody for the PAT. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. Scoring summary, three-play drive. And it was all capped off by a John Metchie touchdown reception. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. He brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started.
Well, probably not much that they can do at this point, CD. Down three scores late in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a little too much to overcome, you would think.
Yeah, they'll go down swinging, but in the end, I think we saw the writing on the wall a while back because one team was clearly better than the other in this one. And while it didn't quite reach blowout status, I think we knew who was going to win this one well before we got to this stage.
Now here's a throw that's complete. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. White now on first down. And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
You know, if this is the regular season, partner, we'd be talking about just how costly a mistake that was, but probably good for him to get it out of his system right now.
Just hope for him and the team it's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, without a doubt. Plus, you got to worry about making the team. Those types of errors don't help you.
They begin the drive with Robinson, and he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Now a give, right side. It's Hawkins. They give him about four on the play, but he's marked short, so he'll be third and about the length of the football. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted.
So it's a victory here for the New York Jets. And it was their defense. offense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Jets as we say so long from MetLife Stadium.
Heart that melted every time we let that flame go was banging out with Elvis, dancing on your balance. recall when we were hiking and surfing and standing trees. And it began to rain, oh, what beauty we found indeed. Since we, you would move on to new things that make you smile like Christmas Eve.